What did I say to piss you off this time?
Who is the Negro in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood? In your neighborhood? I say, who is the Negro in your neighborhood when you're running from his ass each day?
Black people don't hope, we wish.
Something that crazy could only come from you.
Right now you live in belief. You want to believe things. Belief is ignorance. Right knowledge is to know. Understand that? Belief is ignorance because belief is the acceptance of things that you do not know. And every one of your prayers end with Amen.
Let me hear you say amen. Oh, let me hear you say amen.
Amen, which is the ancient Egyptian god, Amun, and the rock was the sun in us as the original people of the sun. And we roamed the earth millions of years, 17 million, 250,000 years exact, before Adam was created 49,000 years ago. Now, we don't know good people from bad. We don't know good food from bad. We don't know good music from bad. We don't know anything, and we were the ones who knew everything. And so they put us under a spell. What kind of spell? The spell of ghost worship. You understand? Ghost worship. And they said gospel. Ghost spell. All you know is what they told you, and you have belief in what they told you. When we were in our right state, state of Elohim, we didn't have beliefs. We knew, because we were the gods that everybody worshiped. They made us hate the rising of the sun by telling us, make sure you don't make fudge while the sun is rising. That's because we were sun people. People trying to get away from the sun made us start hating the sun. How'd they make you hate your hair? No, by telling you to pick cotton. The moment we start tossing our hair and cussing our hair and putting our feet on the grass again, things are going to start opening. We lost our eye and our life is dim.
Whoa, yes sir, yes sir. We're back. From New York to Jamaica to Cali to Japan, Domo Domo live from Ground Zero. It's the fattest 30 minutes on the air. That's right, babies. You know what this is. Your radio show shows Bust That Ass Radio 83.17 FMX. And the X stands for You Never Saw Me Coming When You Never Saw Me. Why was that all up in your ass, the bass? Yo, Black Lenny Bruce on the loose. Who's better than that bald and mini-me? Two-pump chump of a boyfriend. And yes, I'll run rings around that ass flat ass like Saturn. So test me, bitch. And if I say anything to offend you, do you know I'm doing my motherfucking job? Because you have the option of turning me off when I keep turning you on again and again and again and again. Cash your ass. It's Friday, bitches, so let's ride. You know how we start this shit off with LA Racist Entitlement. So here we go with the question of the fucking day. Yeah, that's right. I'm in a party mood. Ha ha. That's right. Okay, so does the nature of corporate manipulation become the herald of the future of socialism by proxy of its totalitarian exploits to free people from government when they're one of the same in the White House? Or how far from the shadow society is the corrupted practice of greed's proverbial Buddha finger up in your ass for deceitful fingering? You be the judge. Okay, a few shows back, I think a week and a half ago, I was intrigued by the level of outside interloping into our beloved state's hypocrisy, proposition war for more money, extorted from the poor. Well, shit changes fast when everybody now sees it for what the fuck I already saw. Check it. The Fair Political Practices Commission is seeking records ranging from financial statements to text messages as a part of an effort to unmask the nonprofit donors who have been accused by activists of improperly hiding their identities. A California regulation says nonprofits cannot conceal a donor's identity if the contribution was intended for a state campaign. At the tune of $11 million that went to the Small Business Action Committee, which is fighting Governor Jerry Brown's tax campaign and pushing a ballot measure to curb unions' political influence. And guess whose that was? It was the Americans for Responsible Leadership, a Koch brother patsy organization out of that steamy shithole you call Arizona. You know, SB, you know, 1070, but show me your papers, you illegal bastard state, okay? The Arizona group, through its Virginia lawyer, has denied violating any rules, according to the document filed in court Thursday, citing that it did not have or that it did not, and has never solicited earmarked contributions for any particular project for which it decides to spend money. As a result, no donor had reason to say that ARL would make contributions to the Small Business Action Committee. Okay, you know where I'm going with this, right? What the fuck? Okay. According to SBAC's charter for fear-mongering mantra, SBAC will take an active part in not only opposing the tax measure, but will support other reforms on the ballot, such as Proposition 31, budget reform, and 32, political reform. Defenders of the status quo are well-funded for these ballot fights, and reformers to be heard must secure resources wherever possible to deliver the message for change. So as not part of the status quo, $11 million just came in from some unknown source to help stop a public from making corporations out of small businesses altogether. Oh, fucking A, they did. Okay, since America didn't learn a fucking thing from, you know, the earmark of business and the abuse of slavery, what better way to consolidate and disseminate individualism to work for the whole as a secular community? Let me break that down. Africans from different tribes en masse in one area are parceled out to the highest bidder, and from there, a plantation set up to represent, and it pretty much looks like the same fucking practice all over again, okay, within the laws of our feeble constitution. At least the moniker stands true, no empire can endure off the back of its slaves, but in Caliwack-ass, well, as well, I mean, you know, the rest of the nation, corporations are buying your vote and selling it to the highest cracker. Still fucking your hood on minimum wage and the promise of an educative equality in the vague reality that they control and have been since the Protestant was kicked out of England for selling pork cookies and harboring Jack the Ripper. Now look at us, a nation of fools trained like monkeys to perform for peanuts by dickless bastards. Guess Mandingo tastes good boiled now, don't it? Think about it. I'll be black after this. Oh my God! Mouse Skittles Facebook report! The stuff I found on my Facebook, crazy, shocking, but true. This sent in from Ass Buster Paradise Gray, a pick report on a Mississippi town being sued for its prison to pipeline shit. Okay, so in other words, you know, from school to prison pipeline, alright? So you go to school, and then from there, you get piped right into prison. So glad institutional racism now has the balls to use Jim Crow effectively. This sent in by Assbuster Noelle Mooney. She has got the most hilarious insight to life. Love it. It's a pick post to those of us who never get too old. It says, I see no good reason to act my age. True and fucking D, goddess. And finally from Assbuster, I don't know if this is, but, you know, this is, but... the guy in the pic has his hands in the right places. From a homie in Chi-Town, ESQ, a pic post of a yoga instructor assisting his female students in a position where it's ass up and his hands on the cracks of their asses. I mean, how the fuck could that be a fail when so many of us are deprived by touch alone? Shit, Ice-T fucking said it first. Bitch, let's get butt naked and fuck.
Gigantor, the space age robot, his power is... bigger than big, taller than tall, quicker than quick, stronger than strong, ready to fight for right against all Titan.
Yeah, you know how this shit works. Black Abarca. The ban is still in effect and good weed is getting scarce. Check it. Marijuana is probably the most consumed natural item among the black community. Nah, fuck it. Every community that needs to, and I put this in H-E-M-P, which spells hemp. This is the acronym. Heal excessive mental pressure. That's what I usually do. But before the pop measure goes into effect, you know, on the March 3rd ballot, the feds are mad busting up shit. 12 people just got arrested on Thursday for involvement in a chain of 9 illegal marijuana stores in Orange and Los Angeles counties. Kind of scary now that, you know, what was once open provided many an overlooked soul a moment of clarity. Okay, a 56-year-old San Clemente resident from whom the narcotics trafficking inspiring was led by John Melvin Walker. This Nino Brown motherfucker operated 9 marijuana stores. You know, fuck that shit. I mean, but he failed to report income to the federal authorities and instructed his bookkeeper to destroy all records pertaining to income generated at the marijuana stores. As this terrorist web emanates from the city council, the enemy is moving like a hot knife through butter. Everything's wide, so what the fuck you think would happen? I mean, it's easy to force kill natural access to freedom and drive it into the underground. Because above it, the penal state says, you know, stays in function. Oh, what? Oh, I'm just doing my part as a hyphenated American to celebrate the bad guy. It's what we fucking do, right? And I'm the one they call not civilized. Humanity, it's a hell of a drug. Here comes the message. Dirty condoms. With budget cuts and layoffs about to hit LAPD, it's quarter time and the high volume of stupidity continues, my niggas. Okay? Look, I don't mind stepping over drunk barrachos, but damn, man, there's no excuse for a dirty butt crack. Okay, what, Mento? You spend all fucking day bumming for change and toilet paper and toilet paper never even entered the equation. Elsewhere, look both ways between 7th, 8th, and Alvarado. Block is hot and niggas is getting popped for jaywalking like roaches when you turn the fucking kitchen light on at 3 in the morning. Cops are hot on the 7th and Westlake corner at night, so watch your stupidity because they're getting raided like there's no fucking tomorrow, man. I swear to God. Fucking ask to the penal state's reason for more meat margaritas.
I came to tell the truth, spread the wisdom to the youth. Gonna make a man mad, but my people have been had. You can't come in because of the color of your skin. And if you do, they call the pigs in blue. Come inside, make yourself at home. Oh, I forgot to mention, leave my daughter alone.
I like your daughter.
My dress, my afro, my body, my fade. My baggy clothes, the trims that I made. My fly ass jeans, my funky deep rims. All the things I did, they credit to him. Hip-hop, hip-hop, rock and roll and jazz. All stolen legacy from my past. Stand up, my people, confess and be proud. Cause we all know the brothers are loud.
members only, but no membership without a credit card. No credit card with less than 5 on the job. No job without experience. No experience without an education. No job.
No education without the loop to finance. But no financiation without an education.
No flipping without tripping. No tripping or flipping. But slipping, you can trip on how you're flipping. But if you trip too hard, then you slip. But trip on how they still keep you paying when you're slipping. They're sticking it in and working it round, mixing it up and saying it loud, saying it loud.
Cover up the real with the drama.
No brothers allowed.
Yeah, it is now time for cultural nepotism. Oh my God, thank you for increasing federal funding to the state of Cali Whackass. We've always wanted the penal state to provide more of a reason for longer incarceration rates for more innocent and coerced prisoners to the bowels of one of the biggest fucking snow jobs this side of the fucking Mississippi. Check it. The gap between supporters and opponents of Proposition 34 at the capital punishment measure is now very small. Only 3% point compared with the last month statistics. Still, less than half the responses say they would vote for the measure, which would replace the death penalty with life imprisonment without the possibility of parole. Okay, with the bait and switch, the bitch for pickles move, its financial ramification and details of the effect on prisoners response flipped. 45% were in favor and 42 against. Still very close to the survey's margin of error, which is 2.9 percentage points. All of which measures with a source and ounce of truth that we'll need more prisons now to offset the current overpopulation. And that the Block family are basically losing money on the ones they've already shut down. Proposition 34 would apply retroactively to condemned inmates, require convicted murderers to work in prison to contribute to victim restitution funds, and direct $100 million to law enforcement over 4 years. Looks like it's going to be a penal state after all. Fine. Got your grill and knuckled up or make plans. Mines was fucking simple. Get all up underneath City Hall and blow that ass up like the Hindenburg.
That's the sound of the police. Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the beast. Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the police. Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the beast.
There is no
kids, my big kid was in the car by themselves until my mom arrived on the scene. They didn't give me my Miranda rights. 11 o'clock came minutes, 11 o'clock on my phone the next day. Then some man coming in with a piece of paper talking about I'm under arrest. But I've been here since 4 o'clock p.m. You just now arrested me. 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock the next morning. So why am I in here if I wasn't arrested? My brother got shot, like they said, in the back of the head, came through Robert's temple, in the back of the leg, in the back. Why did you do that? He said you had a gun. And I've been out there for 10 hours, and nobody find no gun, and nobody find the item that they say in the news that he was trying to take. Where the victim at? You just seen, it wasn't even a phone call, said he robbed somebody. You just happened to be going that way and seen an African-American running and tried to take the suit. You didn't know what was going on until after he was already dead. So why did you kill him? That's what I want to know.
Watch out! We run through y'all!
There is no justification, none at all, for responding with violence.
If I was here just now and said, oh, I feel threatened, I'm licensed to carry a gun, I murdered someone here because I felt threatened, there was no gun found with neither one of them, and the only thing that this family has gotten back was because they're the police department and they felt threatened for their lives, and they were licensed to carry a gun. That's injustice. I feel like there needs to be a thorough investigation. The police, whoever is involved, need to be accountable. Each one of us in here has to be accountable for our actions. Why not them? You know, if this family is hurting, imagine if I took someone like you, imagine your parents not being able to sleep, your kids turning to drugs, your wife losing her mind. It has an effect on everyone. And I feel like there's no effect for them.
This family has gone through a lot, and no one seems to even care about the pain. We're part of society, so what we feel is going to reflect on everyone here. Somebody help bandage us. We're hurting. We're crying. We're protesting, speaking out. Anybody, we're crying for help. Somebody, please do something. This is not right.
There is no justification, none at all, for responding with violence.
Oh, you just walk up and break my bed without saying a word! Oh, boo! Who are you, sir?
That's the sound of the police!
Yes, we have come to the butt end of the show. And I want to thank everybody for hanging out. We've got the 4,000. Thank you so much for the support. And of course, you know we're going to do this because we have to discuss one specific giant pimple that's sitting on that motherfucker's head that's in front of you right now. And you just take your thumbs and pull that fucking face apart and you fucking look inside and you see that brown eye and you fucking do this on one and on two and on three with a mighty Musa. Asshole of the day. That's right. In the world of the free press, one would never guess how far the proverbial foot of the Koch brothers have been embedded into the ass of white-controlled media. Not only do these redneck racists control oil fields in Russia, but damn near everything else here as well. And since you dumb fuckers ain't awake enough to see this shit, let me give you a prime example of extremist thinking, okay? Into the shit rag known as the Daily News of Los Angeles. Like the LA Times and every industrial tampon concerning the echo machine of bullshit news coverage, they are mere slaves to the Koch brothers. Check it. In a recent endorsement for Shit Flick Ramnesia, Cracker Supreme, okay, not only do they go in every direction to prove that Lord Obama wasn't up to par for the job, but when has any, and I repeat, any white racist establishment in the South ever let a nigga win except in death? Okay, so when you have Jim Crow Batty boys in a White House that are so used to what they've been doing since they're the KKK run that bullshit, one can't see the organized crime behind it. Talk about La Costa Nostra and the fucking house. Or as they say in Mob Ran Vegas, nobody beats the house. And that's why it's white. Get it? What the fuck? Okay? This is a Charlie Sheen moment. So ride this dick, bitch. Okay? The fact, since day one, women voted Obama in more so than white men. After all, with 350 years of white government that plans death by capitalistic conquering of the rest of the free white world, enslaving and or killing off nations of color within blood wars for natural resources, which has the fucking nerve to think they can't be touched, it's asking for a death wish. Such corporate arrogance is the follow tool of racism. Lord Obama came in with a unified vision for both houses to work together, but instead got shafted by a shitload of Republican racism infueled by the Koch brothers, the American Illuminati. And they made it clear that for what every effort Lord Obama made to work in the House instead of furthering the now world order agenda. Republicans don't care about the 47%, and there's no other way to color the sincerity of White House racism when they make every attempt to instigate Lord Obama's failure. As a nation, we do die from, okay, the fire of mechanical industry that rapes and ravages beyond human legality, or do the people want to die from such? What, you stupid fucks want a utopia of ecological disasters behind this death rate? Then go the fuck ahead, I'm not wanting to stop stupidity. That's spelled with two O's. Fuck it. Let's posse up and kill the Koch brothers and get that and get the next motherfucker, the number one motherfucking cracker above them. Okay, let's get these assholes out of the fucking way. Now more than ever, people should boycott this shit rag of biased reporting called the Daily News of Los Angeles, as it is the asshole of the motherfucking day. Y'all should know better than that, man. Y'all should know better than that. But then again, I'm not the only one speaking on this shit.
The brothers have been incredibly secretive.
This is a phenomenal success in my judgment. What you have is this organization that has chapters in 34 states. They hold rallies. They bus people into these rallies. They hold politicians' feet to the fire on legislation they want to have passed. Not only do they force politicians to do what they want, but they also have a very strong libertarian agenda, which is against the Department of Education, against public education in general, and affects elections and policies at all levels of government, at congressional elections, our senatorial elections, all the way down to local school boards, as we've seen in North Carolina.
Yeah, that's right. Now, if you missed it, didn't play it again till you get it. You can say moving forward like a bitch, but you know I'm ahead of your bullshit. This has been your radio show, Bust That Ass Radio, 83.17 FMX. And the X stands for You Didn't See Me Coming Whenever You Ever Saw Where I Was At, All Up In Your Ass. That is slacking, rum, pum, pum, harder than ever, booty bubbles and dirty condoms. Music provided by Omega 7 Records, the Mothership Connection, a.k.a. The Struck, and the Universal Underground Music Scene. Check us out at must777.wix.com/bustthat_ass radio and leave a stinky, cause it's all about cash ass, and I'll see you in the street, bitches. Rah!
Ladies and gentlemen, Doc Musco, Mucho Chile. Where else is this going to fucking go?
An organization that has chapters in 34 states. They hold rallies.